Next job is this side. I got to take the wheel off. And, well, yeah, all that basic stuff. Okay, just taking a quick look here. That's the other brake hose. The only difference between the two is there's a little pin, guide pin on these, as far as, you know, what holds them in place when you're bolting it. But this this one here is almost impossible to move. And this was a good side. I can feel the rotor on the back of it. I'll show these all lined up when I'm done here. But I think these have been locking up for quite some time. The hose is hard on the outside, but I can feel on the inside when I push on it. It just wants to collapse. So I guess 70,000 miles and, you know, what is this, 2014. This car's an 06. I guess it's all right. They're, I guess they're allowed to go. Okay, first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to get some PB Blaster. And I'm just going to hit these clips. And the brake line. This stuff does work. I'm also going to hit these bolts because I know I haven't had these sides off in a while. Now comes the fun part, usually. Breaking these back bolts loose. Which, there it goes. I don't have any new hardware in this caliper, so I don't have to worry about really disassembling anything but the old brake hose before turning these cords in. If this one's like the other side, this is probably pretty well stuck, and this bolt here is rusted pretty good. That's what Pennsylvania gets you. Here's the other one. We don't care about the spray hose because it's got to be replaced. That wasn't stuck on as bad as the other side, but that pad's, well, this one pad here isn't too great. So we're just going to leave that there. And oh, this is interesting.
Time to the BFH.
Or the nearest heavy, blunt metal object. Anybody want rust? I'll send it to you free of charge.
Once you get it started, it's good to go.
Not too bad.
Shouldn't have taken that off yet. Because I need to get this on here and crack that loose. The fitting's a little crusty. Probably gonna start leaking fluid. I'm gonna use a line wrench. Here's a little bit of fluid coming out. That's good. Make sure your master cylinder's, you know, got a decent amount of fluid in it, because you do lose some. If you're down low like mine was, you can lose quite a bit of fluid. You don't want to introduce air into the entire system. Luckily, these lines are pointing downwards. This one should just drop out of here. And you get brake fluid dripping. Just reach up in here with this little fitting. There we go. Okay, pretty much the best shot we're gonna get here. What I'm gonna do before I go ahead and put this on, so that we don't do things twice, is I'm gonna get the rotor, clean it, and slide that on there. Pretty much. I cleaned that up a little bit. This rotor here has just a little bit of rust on it, which I'm not happy about. I don't feel like running back to the parts store. It has never been installed because it's still got the crosshatch markings on it. But I'm just going to finger tighten some lug nuts on here, which makes things easier later on down the line. It helps hold this in place.